In 2014, the town of Olenivka in eastern Ukraine fell under control of the self-proclaimed Donetsk People's Republic, DPR, a separatist group now controlled by Moscow. That August, the Volnovakha Correctional Colony No. 120 in the town of roughly 4,500 persons became a prison camp for Ukrainian soldiers and political prisoners captured by DPR militants and the Russian military. 8 years later, in July 2022, a group of between 193 and 211 Ukrainian soldiers were regrouped into a new barracks in the Volnovakha complex. All were members of the far-right Azov unit, which had surrendered on May 16 under a guarantee of protection from the United Nations and International Committee of the Red Cross, ICRC, after resisting beseiging Russian forces for 3 months in the city of Mariupol. Just few days later, in the evening of July 28, a blast consumed their new dormitory in flames, killing at least 53 of the interred POWs and injuring at least 75 and up to 130 more. Gruesome video footage released by Russia and other news agencies show numerous scorched bodies, some reduced to carbonized ashes while sleeping in their beds. No other buildings were damaged, as can be seen in satellite photos, and no guards were killed. The ICRC subsequently requested access to the surviving Ukrainian POWs, the safety of which it had guaranteed, but were refused it. Moscow claimed the Olenivka prison had been struck by a missile fired by a HIMARS rocket artillery system given to Ukraine by the US. The HIMARS's GPS-guided M-31 rockets have proven effective in destroying Russian ammo depots and surface-to-air missile batteries, as well as holding bridges. Russian troops displayed fragments allegedly from the HIMARS strike, though without evidence that they were recovered at the site of the attack. Russian sources claimed Ukraine attacked to prevent the POWs from exposing their supposed crimes, or to discourage Ukrainian troops from surrendering. Ukraine denied it had carried out a strike, and Ukrainian intelligence specifically claimed that the Russian private mercenary company Wagner Group set out on its own initiative to cover up the torture of Azov prisoners by killing them in such a manner to discredit the Ukrainian military and deflate. In effect, besides the supporters of Russia's war in Ukraine, most observers find it far more likely that forces allied with Moscow carried out the deadly attack. Here's why. The prisons used to house Ukrainian POWs was known since 2014. Unlike conventional rocket artillery, which often scatters unguided projectiles hundreds of meters from the designated target, the M-31 rockets used by Ukrainian HIMARS systems are designed to land within a few meters of a pre-specified GPS coordinate, a capability affirmed by holes that have precisely. So the attack couldn't be a case of a random shot landing far off target.